his tail should be a heart? I do. Let's get started.
I'm fine. Okay, so what I want to do is sculpt, start off with my V up here, and that's going to start the shape. So I'm just using a number 4 blade over a 40, and I'm just going to carve out my line here. I kind of already did it, but this is the line, and I'm smushing the coat down so you can really see it. And I'm fluffing up with the wide part of my comb, and I like to move the fluff away so I can really see the shape. And I'm focused on the end of the comb, and that end of the comb is creating a line. So I'm gonna move this away and focus on the comb, and then just create my line. And then the rest I'm gonna do with scissors. It's important to go really short all the way around so that you can then sculpt. So for this, I'm gonna use my straights. I'm actually gonna see what I need. I think it's gonna be a combination of straight shears, curved shears, and thinning shears. This is where we improvise. So I'm gonna start by fluffing everything up. She doesn't really need any product, but if the coat is laying flat, you might wanna put a little product in it to let it stand up. And I'm gonna start with the top part of the heart. I'm gonna grab my curved shears, and I'm just gonna do one chomp here, one chomp here. And then I'm just gonna finesse. Just start shaping, fluff up, check my work. You can really start to see it come together. And you don't want it too boofy here, so I'm really gonna take some length down. And then I'm gonna do the bottom part of the heart. I'm just really careful. One chomp up there, one chomp like that. And we're gonna get the bottom part of our heart. And this is where you can get creative. I'm gonna comb down so I can make sure I set my length. We'll just make sure not to get the goods, only the fluff. Let me get rid of that. Combing everything down with the wide part of my comb. I'm just gonna start shaping. There it is. Once you get this and this, you can really start to see the shape. I'm just gonna take a little length off. Nothing major. Isn't that cute? The key is to have intentional lines. You don't want it to look like you tried to do a heart. Really do it. Commit. And then just make sure, you know, I'm using her whole body as my guide to make sure it's symmetrical. She has a little fluff missing here, so I'm just gonna work with what I've got. Story of my life. I went short today, so I'm really gonna just take all this boof off. You can really see it coming together. Isn't it cute? I love it. So I'm just taking off a little bit at a time, shaping and sculpting a little bit at a time, and just making sure it's intentional and even everywhere. I'm gonna get some thinning shears and kind of round the bottom a little bit. I like a rounded heart. Shaping. So a lot of this is calming down, fluffing, and checking your work, and just finessing until you're done. That looks super cute. So I'm just gonna finesse and keep tweaking it. There's a little fuzz on there. Okay. I have a little bit of color in here, and I have a brush just for coloring. So I'm going to spray a little bit of this and brush it through. You're a loaf. You're a big loaf. Okay, just a little something. And there you go. We have a cute little heart. There it is. So cute. Stunning, gorgeous, my masterpiece. Time for the dismount. Yay! heart, but ain't she so pretty?